Hello everybody, this is Fernando for the latest Aliens and UFOs video. Alright, let's go ahead and let's do another entry here based on one of your new suggestions. When I was reading the information on this one, I instantly thought to myself, this is it. This is a perfect example to showcase here to everyone about aliens and UFOs. You know me, you know I love reading information that's both original, interesting, fascinating as well. This one definitely takes the cake. I mean, some of my past videos, like the alien that cooked pancakes, for example, for someone they encountered, I thought that that one was high up on the list, but no, it looks like this one may actually replace it. And it has to do with an encounter that actually occurred several decades back, but the person that encountered it eventually broke their silence and then told it afterward. And ever since then, it's just gained popularity. So it has to do with this. You're looking at the depiction of the alien here, or the aliens, definitely stands out, doesn't it? It's known as the Robo-Flowers Encounter. So let's go ahead and let's talk about all the info associated with this very unique case, very original case as well. So what was this Robo-Flowers Encounter? Well, it was a one-time occurrence that pretty much only happened to one person as well. Again, a rarity on these things. And it occurred back in 1924, to be specific. There's not really an exact date that seems to be listed as far as that year, but instead it's just 1924, and here's what occurred. There was a woman by the name of Evelyn Wint, who at that time was just a small child, a little girl. She didn't say what her age was exactly, but on that day, she was by her school, which you'll see somewhat of a picture of here. It's not a current picture. Like, in other words, it wasn't a picture at that time in 1924. Instead, it's a more current one. But this is a school that's called the St. Joseph School, which is located in Pasco County, Florida. More on the update on the status of the school later on, too. So she was outside just basically playing around, just doing, you know, just hanging out, I guess. I don't know if she was on break in school or if this was like lunchtime or whatever was the case. But she stated that while she was playing on the lawn, all of a sudden next to her or nearby her, she noticed what was described as an egg-shaped object that was glowing severely, like almost like a very, very bright glow. So bright, in fact, that it caused her to shield her eyes. It makes one wonder, like, if she noticed it beforehand or if it was one of those things where she was so absorbed with her toys or whatever she was playing with that she didn't notice it at all until she suddenly did. Either way, though, this thing was there near her. She was the only one in that area. And this thing apparently was just right there by the school, I guess, pointed towards that direction. So eventually, either she surmised that she fainted from the brightness, or sometimes a small amount of time passed either way, and she didn't realize it, how quickly it went. But the luminosity, the brightness of this thing dimmed. And when she did so, that's when she saw that there was what she described as like a UFO, but it was more like egg-shaped, and it was more leaden or pot-marked is how she described it. So it wasn't just perfectly smooth and metallic like the usual representation of a UFO is. No, this looked like it was something that was used to wear, like it was definitely a used object. Either way, though, what she saw next truly left her astonished. By the way, all of this stuff that she's describing, she kept hidden for about 50 years. In fact, on the 50-year anniversary of her encounter, she finally decided that she wanted to go ahead and share this story with everyone out there. That's how much she kept this a secret for 50 years, five decades. Can you believe that? During that time, afterward, when she finally decided to reveal everything, she contacted a newspaper or a journal called The Weekday, which is located there in West Palm Beach, and then finally decided to tell this story. A reporter actually wrote all this info down and then shared it, and that's why we get all of this info today. But yes, here's what she described. She said, and these are her exact quotes, that when this hatch opened, quote-unquote little people emerged. I think they were robots. I tried to count them, but they changed about so. They were smaller than I was and resembled animated flowers with faces where the bud would be. And remember, I was just a bitty thing, and kids don't fear flowers. So she mentioned this specifically because normally if she saw something along the lines of, let's say, a standard alien or gray, that might freak little kids out. But in this case, they look like tiny flowers with little people's heads on them, smaller than she was, in fact, which probably was another thing that led her to not being so scared, because they were smaller than her. So whatever these things were, they were basically there, all of a sudden surrounding her area, and she further described them carrying something which she told the newspaper that she presumed was a weapon. There's no idea like if this truly was a weapon or not, but that's what she was thinking automatically from it. And she saw them carrying this tiny little thing, and they were pointing it directly to the school. And they were either trying to lift it or trying to point it, but they weren't having a good time, like a good success doing it. So eventually she tried to actually help them out. So if you can believe this, here you have this little girl who's encountering these things from another planet, completely unafraid, and then when she sees the struggle that they're having, she actually tries to help them. In fact, that's what she said specifically. She said, quote, "I wanted to help them. They were so small. I was going to assist. The creatures let me try, but I couldn't even budge the machine." So as tiny as they were, and as even smaller as that device was that they had with them, she couldn't even nudge it one single bit. That's how heavy this thing was. They weren't having any problems, it seems like, lifting it or moving it. They just seem to have issues with trying to set it, I guess, to some specific angle. Either way, though, these things, whatever they were, started speaking to her. This lady, Miss Wint, claimed that they began to communicate with her telepathically, and they were telling her that this building, this school that she was taking classes from, was something that they found disturbing. And they stated this. This is her quote: "If the work continued, they would destroy the place." So whatever was in that building, whatever was occurring, even though that was her school, these robo-flowers found it to be very, very dangerous. Unknown if it was dangerous to them, or maybe they saw it as dangerous to the community, to the planet. We've heard of some stories in the past about aliens or grays trying to educate whoever they encounter about something happening soon that'll be bad for the planet, bad for humanity, something along those lines. So that could be the case here, where you have these creatures, these robo-flowers, trying to prevent something from occurring in that building, so that way it doesn't harm others, or potentially, you know, harm them, but we don't know. All of this stuff remains mysterious to this very day. Finally, at that point, it seems like the robo-flowers, I don't know if they decided to just give up or if they decided this wasn't the right time. Either way, though, they just simply retreated back into their craft. So it's just like at some point, they just simply decided that was it. They're going back there. Remember, nobody else around this area was noticing this. I would imagine that this, between the time she noticed the egg-like mound up until these rubble flowers came out, until they finally retreated, I would imagine it would be around 5 minutes or less, somewhere around there. And this is if you're not including the idea that she didn't discover them beforehand because maybe she was so absorbed in the toys she was playing with. So who knows, maybe they were there even longer on the ground before she noticed them. Either way, though, no one else did. It was just her and the robo-flowers basically interacting with each other. But they decided that it was time for them to leave. And she saw them get into the aircraft. And then that was it. They basically went up into the air and then they left. But before they did so, they sent her one more message. They told Miss Wint this message. They promised, and this is her quote, "They promised to come back for me," her specifically, "in 35 years. But by the time she told this tale, which was 50 years later, clearly that passed. There was no word, no indication that they ever fulfilled their promise. So she stated that that was up a long time ago and nothing happened that I know of. So ever since that time period, ever since they went up into the sky, and the way she described it, she saw the vehicle ascend, and then it made like these weird molecule type changes. All of a sudden it turned from, like I was saying earlier, that used look, like it was something that's been damaged and used. Then it went back to a more silvery bright look, probably the more conventional look that you and I think of when it comes to UFOs. It hovered around the air for a minute and then it was gone. It was completely gone, no doubt probably speeding away at a much faster speed than anything possible. And so ever since that time period, they never came back, but that was the story that Ms. Wendt told that specific newspaper. 50 years later, after her encounter, she finally decided to give that sneak peek to what occurred. A little bit later, too, sometime in the late 70s, she was put under hypnosis to try to see if maybe, just maybe, Evelyn was actually kidnapped, or if she was taken on the UFO for a little while. Remember, there was that period I was mentioning where the thing was so bright she thought it kind of caused her to faint, or the time kind of skipped a little bit. But as it turns out, she wasn't one of those people that could be hypnotized, so nothing was ever found out afterward. But since that time period, I don't know what happened with her specifically, with Evelyn Wendt, but when she recited these things at that time in the 70s, she was a hairstylist and presumably just continued on living as such ever since then. Considering now it's been several decades after, it's unknown. I can't seem to find any info about what occurred to her. Now, as far as the school, remember I was mentioning earlier about the status of it. You're looking at it now. It was destroyed actually back in 2017. I was looking up some information on it, and it looks like this school, all these decades that it's been around, it was finally decided that another school would replace it. I think that's the correct info. It's kind of hard because the article that I was reading didn't mention that specifically, but kind of stated that there was another school that the area was going to go with. So I don't know if they replaced it exactly or if it just happened to be destroyed as is because this other school was being opened separately. Either way, though, the school was destroyed. I was reading also that it's also because this school, because it's so old, it was earmarked with some kind of condition. I don't know what the classification is again, but apparently if a school is classified as such, it doesn't get repairs. So like major repairs, like the usual repairs that most schools get on a continuous basis. So this thing, whatever it was, at least at that point, it was definitely just going to be destroyed. And as you see it there, so that is the status of the school. The aliens, these Robo-Flowers, did not end up destroying it. Eventually, of course, they decided to leave and nothing occurred from it. But eventually, humanity decided to destroy it on its own. Who knows, though, what was within the school? Like, why would it cause these Robo-Flowers to try to point a little teeny tiny cute-like weapon to it to try to destroy it? Nothing has remained. Nothing has been answered from, and it remains a mystery to this very day. Why she was the only one that encountered these Robo-Flowers, who knows as well. It could be something where at the end of the day, just on an extreme end, did she make it up? Who knows either? Like if Evelyn was making it up as a fantastic story, she definitely gave a lot of details associated with it. But still, this is only her encounter. No one else encountered it, and that's remained this way to this day. Unless someone else wants to point out something else, no one else seems to have encountered these unique, very, very original looking Robo-Flowers. So, but that's pretty much it. If anyone has any more info, anything else I might have missed, please post those comments below. Anybody from that area, that Pasco County, Florida area, that happens to maybe know some of the members of that that community, Evelyn specifically, or anyone else, that'd be really, really great to share if you have more insider information for it too. So, all right, everybody. Thanks again as always. Take care.